Jack Hamrady. Fourth place from Ray R. Well. Fifth place from Avondale, Ashley Hamrady. Sixth place from Gatesburg, Jamie Greenville. Seventh place from Meeker, Madison Schultz. Eighth place from Venison, Tyler Holmes. That is the results of class 1705. We'll move on to class 1706. The weight range 1295 through 1313. The entries include Sedgwick's Haley Walterman, from Burlington Cole Rittenauer, from Callahan Bailey Gago, from Ray Laura Welf, also from Ray Baylor Buck, from Platteville Stephen Whitehead, from Longmont Emma Vickland, from Ronnie Cody Huwa, from Eaton Alyssa the Porter. Once again, this is class 1706 of the rig. The weight range is 1295 through 1313.
I'd also like to thank the junior show work, the Showtime Junior Livestock Magazine. They're right out front here, even on the web stream right there. It is Showtime Junior Livestock Magazine. We're in. Look for videos from all the junior livestock shows online at the showtimesmagazine.com. We'd also like to thank the Morgan County Commissioners for their generous donation allowing the Carter State Fair to use the Porta Cool units again this year. Others contributing to the Cougar Fund include Colorado Elite Club Lamb Producers, Ranchway Feeds, and Dr. Jill Parker from Mesa Veterinary Clinic. If you would like to help donate and continue the fund for Porta Cool, please see the livestock office to make a donation. Any and all support would be appreciated. Once again, put your hands together for Showtime's Junior Livestock Magazine and also our Porta Cool sponsors. We appreciate that.
black on my face.
Get him a few things.
can go without being said that this is a tough class. Really, really got a lot of heat here and very, very deep. And then even some of the cattle we have here in fourth and fifth, depending on a different guy, different day, these five will be switched around a whole bunch of different ways. But I think when you get to studying these cattle, and I apologize for it, maybe take a little more time, but one of those classes you just want to try to get as right as possible. Here's easily the problem for anyone. I think he's one of the cattle in here that got a really good, solid, fat steer look about him. Love his hip and hind leg and the way he's designed there. He's absolutely the best one at the ground. I think that's where he really kind of separates himself in this class. He's got the muscle and body that everything else has, but his skeleton's still in check. He keeps pigs right. He's a little plainer up front. That's what maybe what you change about that calf, but from the shoulder back, I think that's by far the best one we have here in this class, a nice calf here. These next two I go back and forth on. Both of them got structural problems. You like to change and amend. I think standing still, there's no question which one I like better with the young ladies here. This one has got a killer look from the side. Outstanding rib shape and muscle for that one. And honestly, his length of stride is fine for the way he's built. He just needs bigger feet. That would have bigger feet, then he looks more comfortable moving, then he looks like one that maybe needs to take a hold of the first spot. For me today, those feet are just giving him a little too much trouble to keep him out of that top hole there. Calf we have here in third, another very, very good steer. I think one is very good in his kind. He's got some body, he's got some top and some hip in him. I don't like his hocks. To me, he's just one of the big, big horse hocking, staying a little too bow-legged there. For me, also, it gets a little staler, maybe plainer there up front, tucks up into his flank just a shade more. But one in terms of just hip dimension and power, he's got that. Just want to change the way he's designed there, his hock and his foundation touch more for me. Interesting calf to study here. Don't make him any bigger body than that. A very, very muscular, big hip one. And he's got a decent look to him. To me, he's still at the balance of, he's too frail at the ground, a little small footed. It's uncoordinated when he moves. Then when I get my hands on him, to me, he's the patchy finish one. Maybe doesn't handle as fresh and good as I want to. I'll be honest, the problem calf for me was this one right here. Because if you call it and say he's got enough to him, you sure can run him up higher. That's a beautiful steer from the side. Got a heck of a look to him. Not enough show steer for me in this class. Just needs to be more opened up all the way through. Wants to get a little base snare. Get your hands on him. He handles quite a bit softer there.